My name is Anu Doda. I head up engineering for Thomson Reuters corporate tax and trade business. At Thomson Reuters, we offer highly specialized information-enabled software for legal, government, tax accounting professionals, combined with the world's most global news service writers. Across the globe, we have 500,000 plus customers, which includes law firms, federal courts, CPA firms, and Fortune 1000 companies. And as you all know, Reuters News is accessed by billions of people worldwide every day. We combine our unique, trusted content with world-class AI and machine learning and best-of-breed software to power the professionals to help turn the wheel of commerce, uphold the rule of law, catch bad actors, report the facts, and inform people all over the world. The work we do strengthens the society. As you can imagine, we are faced with many of the same challenges you all face in terms of scale, regulatory compliance, and data security in supporting our business growth and customers. Here in corporate tax and trade segment, we focus on the software that helps tax professionals with necessary research and regulatory updates. And we facilitate the calculation of the indirect taxes, such as sales tax, VAT, or GST, help companies file their corporate taxes with the authorities, and also move them through the global supply chain, ensuring their trade compliance. Every year, we incorporate millions of changes into our software to help maintain the accuracy and transparency for our customers and authorities. Like many of you here, as a technology company, it is very important to us on how we do things as much as what we build for our customers. Hence, our journey to cloud has started in 2018, which is all about delivering more value to our customers and doing it faster. And I think it happens for two reasons. First, cloud enables us to spend less time managing the infrastructure and building diagnostic tools. Rather, we focus on making our solutions more resilient and robust. And by working with leading cloud providers like AWS, we can add capacity on demand while focusing on incorporating regulatory changes into our solutions, so we don't miss a beat on that front. Second, when your software is on cloud, you get access to all kinds of great tools from cloud providers and partners. Using those tools will give you the advantage of best-in-class solutions across things like security, data management, and modern technologies. What that means is we can focus on building what matters to our customers by leveraging those capabilities rather than reinventing them. I won't spend a lot of time on our migration journey here, but I'll say that we've now successfully migrated over 54 customer-facing applications, and that is just in my organization, but we continue to migrate more and more as we go as a company. However, we did not stop there with the migration to the cloud. We have also started reinventing our solutions using AWS capabilities because we want to give great experience to our customers. One such example I want to highlight here today is our indirect tax next-gen data and analytics solution, which helps our customers to reconcile the transactions for which we calculated the taxes into their internal systems like ERP and do further analytics to help enable different aspects of their commerce activities. We process millions of transactions every day for the customers, and the data keeps growing both from our existing customers and with the new. Our previous solution had many limitations in its ability to process large volumes of data, customization of reports, and data extraction. While it was costly, we could not scale it either. So in this solution, we've used Amazon Aurora to feed from our tax engine by taking advantage of many Aurora features as a global database with reader and writer instances, along with the cross-region replication and failover. And then we use step functions and EMR services, and we stage the data into S3 and use Redshift as a data mart to handle all report sizes. The solution is a one-stop shop for customers to reconcile the transactions processed for tax calculation into their internal data, which is very important to them. And then we did not stop there. We've also connected this solution with our compliance application, where tax compliance analysts spend a lot of time in preparing the data to file for their monthly reconciliation reports with the authorities. So it helped this particular connection gives them a lot of productivity in what they do in their process. So since we've been on this journey, which is about a few years now, we've been able to support our customers file millions of tax returns every year across our corporate tax solutions, and be able to seamlessly support the year-over-year increase that comes with new customers as well as the existing customers. The fun part for me in the corporate tax space is really watching how we scale from hundreds of servers to thousands of servers on the filing day as the filing activity increases given the deadline. And similarly, in the indirect tax space, we've calculated taxes for over 3 billion transactions in less than a year and had almost 115% year-over-year increase. But we did that with 6 times improved performance. We've also shifted our uptime metric to be better than ever across our solutions. Since our indirect tax engine is generally integrated with customers' business-critical systems, like ERP or their e-commerce sites and things like that, we've also been able to offer zero downtime deployments for our product releases. As a technology leader, nothing gives me more pleasure than advancing the technology posture of our solutions with modern technology and innovation. And we are totally able to do that by working closely with AWS. Thank you for your time.